Good afternoon, and a very warm welcome to First Presbyterian Church on this beautifully sunny but cool afternoon here in Evansville. It's a great delight to have all of you here. We're so thrilled you've been able to make it to this concert of live, real, human-produced music right here in the heart of our city. If you have one of these, please switch it completely off. If you want to watch the concert later, it is being live streamed and will be on the church's YouTube channel. I also need to let you know that the restrooms on the ground floor are out of order. So should you need the restroom, exit through this door. If you go all the way to the, like a T, way off down the hallway in this direction, there is a small children's bathroom there, or you can go upstairs and keep turning left and keep turning left until you see four old dead white guy composers on a poster, and then you have arrived. So, without further ado, it gives me enormous pleasure to welcome Charles Dupreez and Kristin Jones.
All right, hello everyone. Thank you so much for coming today and joining us for a nice afternoon, almost spring recital. We're in late winter, but we decided to wear nice bright colors because spring is in the air. That first piece was by French clarinetist and composer Paul Jean-Jean. You'll see on the program that the last piece is also by him. A lot of his music is a little bit flashy. You'll hear a lot of seventh and ninth chords happening, and he's also well known for very difficult etudes. So fortunately, I practice his etudes, and now the pieces don't seem too bad. The next two pieces I'll be playing are by Hungarian composer Georgi Kertok. The first only lasts about 30 seconds, so for a moment, right? And then one, the homage to Johann Sebastian Bach, is supposed to be in the style of Bach, as if Bach had lived in the European post-war avant-garde musical climate. So I hope you enjoy the next two pieces. We now move on to Cello Suite Number 2 by Bach. I've always loved playing Bach, and in recent years, especially playing Bach on the bass clarinet. So the piece that you will hear is in the original key, so it's been transposed to the clarinet, so you'll hear it, other than the fact that it's on clarinet, the bass clarinet, but it's in its original pitch. So enjoy the next one. So one thing you might notice on my bio on the back is that during my doctoral degree, I did a lot of electroacoustic-based clarinet. So what's good about electroacoustic music? If you squeak in it, people might not know. Whereas Bach, if a squeak happens, which on bass clarinet in 15 minutes of playing is likely, you can't really hide that. So that's just one of the things of live performance that makes it more fun. So we move on to some Lieder by Schubert. So these are adaptations of actual vocal pieces, which you'll have the translations, or you should have the translations. Share with a partner if you don't. But I like to play vocal pieces for various reasons. First of all, sometimes they're a lot more pretty than instrumental music. I know some vocalists will agree with that. And secondly, I think for instrumentalists, it helps just to develop a more vocal and lyrical playing style. So I hope you enjoy the next three selections. Thank you. So thank you again for coming. Hope you've enjoyed it. The last piece is going to leave on a more happy note, I guess you could say, in contrast to the Gretchen piece. So Au Clair de la Lune, it's a French song. I'm not gonna sing it, I'm not a great singer, but the melody.
You'll recognize it.
You'll recognize it. So it's a big variations based on this simple theme. So I hope you enjoy, and thank you again for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you once again for coming. Hope you enjoyed everything. Feel free to linger around, chat, come ask me questions. Otherwise, yeah, have a very good rest of your day.